doing it.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hello, Toastmasters.
You won't need all
I hereby call this meeting of Lake Mary Toastmasters Club 6440 to order. Before we begin, please silence your cell phones. I would like to ask everyone to please stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. Our club mission is to provide a supportive learning environment through which members feel empowered to become better public speakers by developing their competent communication and leadership skills. This morning, I would like to introduce our Toastmaster for the day, Mr. Sam Bailey.
Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. This is our theme for today. My childhood, growing up, all throughout the house, every single memory I have involves Star Wars. And today, I would like to take just a little bit of time and share some of those memories with you, but I would also like to be able to give you a better understanding of Star Wars through one of the most important, popular, and foundational icon of Star Wars there is, the clones. So today, we're gonna go through the clone history, per se, from episodes 1 to episode 6. I don't know what they're gonna do with episode 7, 8, 9 because it's Disney, but we'll get there when we get there. First off, you may not have known, the clones were actually made off of a bounty hunter named Jango Fett, whom was the most notorious in all the galaxy, but his clones were made to have half the age, as well as their amygdala was tampered with so that they would not have fear. And they were also made a tad bit more docile so that they would follow orders, making them some of the most perfect soldiers in the galaxy. The one condition, however, that this bounty hunter had is that he wanted a son for himself. So he had a clone without all these modifications made called Boba Fett, who actually became an even greater bounty hunter than his father, which that is a picture down him fighting a giant dragon. That's the kind of dude he was. But speaking of people fighting dragons, I would like to introduce our first speaker of the day.
No.
Oh, technical dating. Oh, my goodness. I said that. Oh, my goodness.
That's a fool's only here.
You had drugs here.
The force is not with you. No, it's not. And that's why I joined the group. I'm excited to wait for the right hand.
Focus, trust.
Let's start off with our second table, our Alcon, on counter, Stephen Moore.
Wow. Oh, great one there.
Thank you.
As I counter, I'm going to be listening to any particular verbal foibles that you may use. Pregnant pauses, tongue clicks, any other crutch words that you tend to use. I also brought along my little trusty clicker. Everyone here groaning. For the record, most of you, you'll visit many Toastmasters clubs where such is used. I am willing to use it for those willing to hear it, which gives you the immediate feedback on the spot when you're actually doing it. Instead of afterwards, you're going, I had that many, I didn't hear them. Which is the point. I have no problem doing it to the Toastmaster Table Topics Master and General Evaluator. Is there any speaker evaluator who would be willing to take up the clicks coming in the middle of their speaking?
No, thank you.
Stephanie?
I don't care if you use it.
Mike's okay. So you might hear a little bit of them.
Rich?
I will be taking notes and reporting to General Evaluator at the end of the meeting, my counts.
Thank you. Here we go to Mr. Gus Davis.
Thank you.
The
forces with me. My function is to time the speakers, three speakers, the three evaluators, and the table topics, whoever that may be, to ensure they meet the timing requirement. I will demonstrate lighting cards that you are well aware. The two speakers will be doing 5 to 7 minutes. At 5 minutes, you will see the green. At 6 minutes, you will see the yellow, and red means stop. We have one speaker who will be doing 3 to 5 minutes. At 2 minutes, yellow. At 2.5, a green. At 2.5, yellow. And at 3 minutes, you will see the red. Table topics, 30 seconds, green. Yellow at 45 seconds, and red at 1 minute. Evaluators, green on 2 minutes, yellow on 2.5, and red on 3 minutes. You'll be disqualified if you go beyond your time. And I'll give my report at the end of the meeting.
Hello, Toastmasters. As grammarian, it is my function to select a word of the day to help build members' vocabularies. Each member, when called upon to speak, is encouraged to use the word of the day. Other members may gently tap on the table when they hear the member use the word. Today's word is abattoir, which is a slaughterhouse. In addition, I will be listening for any errors in grammar, as well as excellent word selections. I will be also noting any colorful thoughts or phrases members that use. During the evaluation portion of the meeting, I will present my report. Thank you.
Neglected our technical table. I was going into this whole speech about slaying dragons and bringing a group with you. And the question that you need to ask is, do you have a close-knit of group of people to help you walk through life? Introducing our first speaker, Dana, with who is your small group?
Kind of scary with all these things up here.
Good morning, fellow Toastmasters. Nice to see you.
Morning.
Morning. Morning.
Well, the man was staring up at his ceiling, 3 a.m. in the morning. He couldn't sleep at all. What was on his mind? He's thinking about, how am I going to pay my bills this month? He's also thinking about, man, my little kid brother, he has cancer. How's he going to beat that? And probably the biggest challenge of all was, how am I going to get along with my 16-year-old daughter? What can I do? Everything I do seems that she just doesn't like it. What can I do? So as he sat there contemplating for the next couple hours, the alarm goes off at 6 a.m. Ready for another great day of his workplace. It was a abattoir kind of a place. There was actually quite a few dragons in his workplace. But like most days, he kept it all inside. Went about his job just to make it through another day. So he could have one more restless night, 3 or 4 more that week, just to make it through. All of that he was holding inside. How wonderful would it be for that man or woman to be able to have a small group to help him walk through those challenges of life? So what's a small group? It's not a group of people like me and Sam, under 5'8", you know?
Yes.
And Gus, you know, we're small.
You know? We have no province.
Yeah, exactly. But a small group, what is a small group? A small group, you may have heard the term several times. A small group is really a group of 3 to 5 people that you would consider very close, dear friends. And what's kind of the attributes of a small group? Small group would be you meet regularly. You, let's say here at Panera, I see some guys meet out at the table after Panera every week. that would be considered a small group. You share in your life's challenges, but you make it a point to stay in contact with each other throughout the week. So what are three aspects of a small group that can provide the direction and the help you need to walk on life's journey? Well, the first thing is, it's a place to be known. Second of all, it is a place to be encouraged. Third, I'll leave that one for the end. So a place to be known. You know, we all really, when we get down to it, we do want to be known. And what is it to be known in your small group? Simple things like, where's my family background? Where are we from, Ernst?
Germany,
right? He might not ever be asked that in the workplace. We want to know where, you know, well, his workplace, hopefully, because it's his wife. So, but where do we come from? What's our family background? Were we adopted? Did we move from another country? How do we celebrate holidays in our family? Just to get to know you. What's your career? What do you do? I mean, we talk in here, but do we really know what each one of us does? In the context of the small group, we'd have more detail of your life. How about your goals? What goals do you have in life? Whether it's fitness, whether it's academics, you know, and getting into Harvard and schools like that, get to understand what really makes you tick. So to be known is very important to us. And then there's other things to be known about, like what are our fears? What are the things that every day we really kind of go, gosh, how's this ever going to get accomplished in my life? How will this dragon ever be beat in my life? So to get to know someone takes time, takes the commitment of getting together as the group. The second thing is encouragement. Once you get to know someone, you find out about their life, you realize, hey, as a group, as friends, we can encourage you. Because we all need encouragement. Do we all need encouragement? Do you need encouragement, Ernst?
Absolutely.
When you're out there running, do you need encouragement?
Talking to myself every day.
Talking to yourself every day. Well, you're your own small group. That's unique.
One man group.
And to be encouraged, to be someone's cheerleader, to say, hey, you can do it. You can reach your goals. You can achieve what you want to do. Hey, you're going through a tough time. You're sick. Your child is having problems with the law. We're here for you. We're here for you to talk to. We're encouraging you. How can we help you? How can we advise you? Having that encouraging place is really critical in our lives. And so many people don't have it. It's the guy that goes to work 5 days a week and come home and have another restless night. Third, and the most important place of having a small group, it's a place to be loved. Because truly, we want to be loved. Deep down, whether it's from other men, other women, our family, our friends, we want to be loved. And in that context of the small group, when people really get to know us and we trust them and they trust us, we can start sharing our life at a deep, intimate detail. And they can love us. So when you're up at 3 a.m, you don't have to be alone. You can call your friend in your small group and say, hey, I'm not sure if I can make it to tomorrow. And because of that love, you have someone to help you journey through life. So to everyone in our Toastmasters group, I ask, other than Ernest, who is your small group? Are you out cultivating relationships to help yourself and also to help other friends to get through life? I strongly encourage you to do this. It will have a tremendous impact on your life and in your friends' lives as well. Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster.
Good.
Now, as this theme is just a little bit different today, we're going to go ahead and go into our 1 minute evaluation.
They make my job high.
I went ahead and left all my force at the door. Yeah.
No doubt.
Part of being a gender. We can't go through me. Thank you, Mr. Timer. So, as obviously everything else is going today, it's just our scrambles and discombobulate. It's a abattoirs for this session. But we got a slight change in the schedule. As it turns out, it is someone's final speech today, and I neglected it. So, up next, for our next speaker, we have someone who is quite an accomplished Toastmaster. For this speech, she will be traveling all the way to South Carolina for a wedding for her goddaughter, a rose by any other name, is a speech she is prepared to give on this happy occasion. Help me welcome to the lectern, distinguished Toastmaster, Stephanie Byron. Dear one, you've heard the story before. How some of us wanted your name to be Christina, the Spanish version, and others argued for the French, Christine, to go with your French surname, Mirren. Christine won out, and so that is who you are today. We should have known, however, from your first baby steps, where you refused all help, that we were raising a fiercely independent child who would have the ultimate say over her name. We have loved you, reared you, educated you in the finest schools, taken care to introduce you to a world larger than our own, and we are so immensely proud of the choices, the decisions that you have made. You continued your education. You moved to Spain, embraced the language and the culture, made a decision for God, and ultimately, you're marrying Jaime. To you and Jaime, I say, well done. I am so overjoyed to be part of this wedding celebration. And I'm even happier that you chose to invite the Lord Jesus Christ to the wedding. May you continue to welcome his presence in your life and into your marriage. Let us all raise our glasses. Long life, divine health, happiness overflowing, and much prosperity. Gloria a Dios. Here we go. In Star Wars Episode 3, it was, oh, excuse me, 1 minute. Oh my goodness.
I need to do my job now.
I know. I'm so excited. This is my passion. It's my childhood I'm telling you about here.
Keep walking. Your childhood
came out before you were born.
Hey, I had some time to catch up.
Okay.
Stephanie and Rich.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Timer.
Yes.
So, Star Wars Episode 3 was probably one of the most sad and yet satisfying episodes in all of the Star Wars saga. The reason for it is not only were all the Jedi killed off by the clones, but it finally brought in all the answers we had been craving for from Episodes 4, 5, and 6, the original trilogy, to George Lucas going back and creating Episodes 1 and 2 and leaving that key factor out of all the movies. So though it was incredibly sad, it answered so many questions that we all had. And it was something that was new, something unexpected. Kind of like our next speaker. Come on up here. You didn't like that introduction? Come on, that was pretty solid.
That was good.
It was, you gotta admit. Especially since it's Walking Amongst Giants, a day in my life of the Calendar Man.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Mr. Toastmaster.
When I was in my 20s, I had three dream jobs a man in his 20s could ever hope for. I was a DJ and motivational dancer for Party Patrol DJs in New Jersey. I was a bartender for the hottest nightclub in Jacksonville, and I learned how to blow fire from my fingers. But the most empowering job and the career that defined the man I am today was I was a male dancer for the Florida Suncoast Calendar Men. This group was the biggest group in Florida and inspired the movie Magic Mike. Channing Tatum came from my group. It was a very empowering time in my life. Now, when people usually think male dancer, they usually get these type of reactions. They chuckle, or they're curious, or they're a little offended. But I'll tell you this, in my opinion, only 1 in 10,000 men can do this job. You had to be good looking. You had to be in shape. You had to be charismatic, and you had to have stage presence. Usually when also people think of that lifestyle, you think low life, taking advantage of women. Now, I will not say that boys were not boys at certain times, but we had a brotherhood. We had a small group. We made each other better. The reason why it was so empowering, I want you to imagine this. Everybody close your eyes, and I want you to imagine that you're on stage, and we had sometimes up to 400 to 500 women in our crowds. And you see a sea of faces, and the lights flood your skin, and the music hits your ears, and screams fill the air. Could you imagine how empowering that can be? That's the life I led. You're almost in a rock concert. Now I want to introduce you to the men that I worked with, the men that helped me make the man I am today. First, up to the stage, 6'2", 230 pounds, dark hair, dark eyes, Jason Woods. He was a black belt in martial arts and wushu. He used to do a butterfly kick that where his body was literally parallel to the ground, spin, and go into a split. We had the leader of the group, Adam Steele, 6'1", 225 pounds, blonde hair, blue eyes. He was our blue collar worker. He did gymnastics on stage. Every group needs a black guy.
Absolutely.
We called him sexual chocolate. 5'10", 5'11", 215 pounds.
Don't quote the time.
And then we had my best friend. 6'6", 240 pounds. He was a mountain of a man. We're still best friends to this day. Jimmy was a part of a group, before he was a calendar man, he was a part of a group called Fourth Wish. He was a professional singer. His group opened for Boys to Men. These were not just dancers. These were performers. Then you had me, the short stick of dynamite. The jiggle from Jersey. Why do they call me the Jingo from Jersey? Well, I have a natural talent that I still hold to this day. That I can shake my butt cheeks really fast to the rhythm of the music and still do a hip roll. I was the Jingo from Jersey. Now, why? No, I would rather not bring that. I would rather not bring that into Toastmasters today.
Wait, is everything else going on today?
It goes with this beat. Work it.
Careful,
man. That's the reaction that you get.
It's a water alert.
Why am I bringing this part of my life in? Recently, I went to go and visit my best friend, Jim. And as you all know, I went on a spiritual journey for about 2 years, and I have not dated in 2 years. And I told him my concerns about going back into the dating world, the dating pool, and having a sex life again. Because as a male dancer, you learn a lot about women. And they don't believe you until it's too late. You learn how to attract them, flirt with them, and please them. And I was concerned about going back into the dating world. My best friend, as I'm sitting across from him, gives me a confused glare. And he looked into my eyes and he said, "Rich, you walked amongst giants. Not only did you walk amongst giants, nobody noticed. And you became one of the star performers of the group. How could you possibly lack confidence in this area?" When he told me that, I got that sense of empowerment again. It flooded my spirit and my soul, and I felt magical again when he told me that. That dancing did not train me to be that fantasy man. It brought out what was already there. And if it's okay with you, I'd like to bring a piece of my past here today.
One second, let me get
ready. Lori.
Within reason, I'd like to put on a little performance. Can we? Is that okay with you guys?
Yeah!
Us? You might as well bring those cards away.
Bring it. Where's our money?
Hey, go. I'm going to share a little bit of piece of my past here with you today. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
You didn't collect the money?
I do birthdays and bachelorette parties.
You didn't collect the money?
You
didn't collect the money for the guy?
Membership will double.
Let's give him one more round of applause.
Hey, he's recorded.
Screw Star Wars. This is a great gig. I'm enjoying this. This is good. We got from 1 minute and everything else.
You did it. 1 minute.
1 minute. Yeah, we got to cut it down. Give him a 2 minutes.
Get the box
now. Water break.
Strange reaction. Yeah. Really uncomfortable or like very intrigued.
Never be the same.
Warrior, as your
man. I'm feeling good.
Wow.
Brutal.
My son.
Good job, brother. Good job.
Thank you.
I was so waiting for someone to be washing a cloth.
I know.
All
the
time we have people watching.
How do you improve? Since you take your pants off.
How do you improve?
Yeah. So did she
improve? How are we doing, Zachary?
I'm getting there.
Wow. You need a few more extra seconds for yourself.
Anyway. I can say this about cheeks. Show, show.
Thank you, Mr. Timer. All right, forget Star Wars. Let's just move on to the next portion of the meeting table topics. Bring it on in.
I love Star Wars, although you're growing up with Star Wars a lot different than mine because yes. I remember the original movies yes. in the 70s.
Yes.
But I went to an orchestral showing of Star Wars where they talked about that each of the characters had their own theme music, and they went through all of the themes. It was fascinating. It was hosted by the man who played C-3PO. And with that, I want to know what your theme music would be. Honey.
Oh,
fix it.
Thank you, Table
fix
Topics.
It.
Madam Table Topics Master. I was even listening. Something about theme music.
What would your theme music be?
My theme music. Okay. My theme music would depend solely on the occasion. So whenever I go and meet Rich, my theme music is Hot Chocolate from the Full Monty. When I meet Mike, my theme music is Wah! Huh! Good guy, yo! What is it?
Okay,
time's up, thank you.
Movie or episode do you like the best and why? Lori.
My favorite Star Wars movie is the original one with Luke Skywalker and Mark Hamill because I saw that movie in a huge theater with a bunch of other elementary school kids at the time. I couldn't understand what the big deal about Mark Hamill was until I saw him in the movie, and then I became a Mark Hamill fan and fell in love with him until I saw the next episode, and then I liked Harrison Ford because, you know, there's no
because he's like Harrison
yes,
Ford.
Yes, exactly. So that was my favorite Star Wars episode.
Wow.
And who is your favorite Star Wars character? Marty.
My favorite character was R2-D2, but only because I grew up with Lost in Space, so I love the robot. So R2-D2 always reminded me of my childhood with my toy robot, which I did get for Christmas in 1910. Always cherished it, and that when that came movie came out, it reminded me so much of that happy time, and I always loved that little droid and all the little noises that it made.
Okay, what do you think about George Lucas going back and adding in new scenes in the 90s when he re-released episodes 4, 5, and 6? Julia.
Wrong person to ask that question. I don't know Star Wars at all.
What religion? Get out, religion.
So I'm familiar. I've seen one movie, I think the first one, years ago, but I am clueless on that. And I don't know why I never got the Star Wars bug, but I know nothing about Star Wars. Ask me about Rocky movies. I saw all the Rocky movies.
Okay,
so,
okay.
You know, that theme song that I used when I was growing up. I think I shared that one time. Anyways, sorry, I'm not a Star Wars fan.
All right. Okay. You're talking.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
All right. Let's put 1 minute on the clock. I actually got it this time. Or is it
tell me?
I'm going
home,
guys. Man, where is the force when I need it? Overall, though, Star Wars for every generation has brought something different to the table. And with the new movies coming out, though it may not be something that you and I look forward to, it is something that our kids will be able to enjoy, and then they can go back and look at my generation of Star Wars, your generation of Star Wars, and all those little awkward phases in between. But on all the overall, this brings us into our evaluation portion. And please help me welcome Macarena.
Thank you. It is now time for the evaluation portion of our meeting. And coming up is Alexandra Balda, who will be evaluating Dana Mitchell on his speech.
Thank you, fellow Toastmasters, General Evaluator, and Dana. Dana was presenting today project number 4, How to Say It. The objective of this project was to eliminate any jargon, use vivid words, and select the right words and sentences to communicate the message. Dana, I have to say that you did a magnificent, you definitely used a magnificent use of vivid words, descriptive words. I love the opening. You got me on the opening when you say the man wasn't sleeping, and right there you set up the mood for the whole audience of what's going on. I was feeling that the man's pain, I was going through that journey when you started the story. I love the fact that you introduce an element from your environment, you use the painting, you use the audience, you ask questions, you were really totally engaged. From that end, beginning of your speech, it was a great segue to introduce the title. So you paint the man, the person's pain, and then it went directly and beautifully into the title of the speech. I love the fact that you use the rule of three. That's always a good technique to use. The place to be known, what is a small group, a place to be encouraged, and last but not least, a place to be loved. Great, great use of that technique. You are bringing natural talents. I can tell you're coming from sales. Is that your background? I mean, you feel comfortable with the audience. You have a great body posture. You engage in the audience. It seems that you pick Ernst to be your person to be introducing into the story. And that was amazing. I really like that. What I will improve, Dana, is I wanted to see at least, I know because of time, one personal story, at least one. So that's the only thing that I will suggest next time, introduce something that bring it real. Other than that, the ending with an opening question, who is your small group, is like where you wrap the whole speech up. That was magnificent. I believe you use simple, short, and clear words in your presentation. That was one of the purposes. As well, your speech completely was clear and effectively organized. And I'm looking forward to listen to the next one. Thank you.
Our next evaluator, Mike. Oh, I'm sorry. A little change of schedule here. Martin Bell will be evaluating Miss Stephanie on her speech. Let's welcome our next Martin evaluator.
Still see a bunch of smiles out there that we're not going to be able to wipe off. Including you, Stephanie. Great speech. All right, so Stephanie's speech today was to do a toast and personalize an occasion or a person of honor. And Stephanie, I believe you did that very effectively today. And you were able to personalize the toast on the offset by describing the person of honor, and you made great eye contact with Carrie as a person of honor, and shared with the group her names, her three names to personalize the toast. And you also recalled like her first steps, brought everybody into the history and your relationship there. Were stories or anecdotes used well? I believe so. Stephanie had good use of stories and anecdotes by sharing her education, the trip to Spain, and basically saying, you know, we all love you for the things that you've done, the decisions that you've made. How effectively did the speaker use vocal variety? I thought you did very well in making eye contact with Carrie from the onset. I believe you may have wanted to try a little bit more vocal variety and some of the things maybe to improve the speech next time, as it was your goddaughter, correct?
Mm-hmm.
May have been to step up and actually make contact with the person. If it is a familiar relationship, going to the person, maybe even with a hug, to personalize the toast when you're raising the toast in that type of situation may actually work. In addition to that, I believe it was a wedding, right?
Mm-hmm.
You did mention the husband's name, Jaime,
yes.
But very, very quickly. So Jaime may have been like, oh, well, does she really like me? Or
well, he's the second one.
That makes sense.
He was not our first choice.
Forget that. Makes perfect sense. But I love the toast. The best thing about a toast is the toast. And to say, you know, a long life, divine health, happiness overflowing, that is where it hits the spot, and I think you did very well. So congratulations, Stephanie.
Thank you. Our last evaluation of the day will be coming from Mike Hughes, which will be evaluating Rich.
Allow me to introduce you to the abattoir, Rich Master, who nailed it today with a speech that really hit the high points. What we're looking for is a speaker needs to use words, an arrangement of words that effectively communicate your message to the audience. And I think you did that. I think you did a very good job. Was the speech appropriate for the assignment? I'll say, well, you know, ifs, long, was hold on to that. Did the speaker use simple, short, clear words? Yes, you did. Very well. Vivid descriptions? Yes.
Oh, yeah.
There were words in there. He described the guy as great.
Yes. A jiggle from Jersey is about all I could pilot, so I was moving along. The speaker used words more than one meaning. I didn't hear anything that had multiple meanings, but I'm sure there's probably something in there. Again, back to question two. So, were speaker sentences short, simple? Yep. Did the speaker reach oracle devices to enhance his ideas? Mm. Really? Avoid jargon? Yeah, you avoided jargon. I think you did pretty good. You didn't. No issues with that, right? So, why am I doing this? That's a good question. Why am I up here? Purpose clear? Yeah, I think it is. And I'm using bones intentionally. So, yeah. How can I make it better? I want to see a little bit more hip. Secondly, if you bring a girl with you for the guys in the room, I really would have appreciated that. Excellent job. Love the story, but never again, please.
Let's start with our awe counter.
Not one
clicker. Madam General Evaluator, it's been an abattoir out here today, has it not? Samuel, I heard a so, a button, an and.
Okay.
Gus and Tony, clean at least so far. Dana, two you knows, seven so's, a button, two ands, four tongue clicks, two wells, and five double clutches.
Okay.
Stephanie, clean.
That's
Rich, three ands, four DC, double clutches. And of course, we saw quite a bit of butts going on.
Thank you.
That was great.
Carrie, one buck, one double clutch, one with that.
Yeah.
Heidi, one so. Lori, you know, a so and an and. Marty, a so and an, two double clutches. Julia, an un, you know, two so's, a but, a clutch. My brain is clean. Mike had one, one, you know, one so, two double clutches, and one that didn't do good. Martin, 10 uhs, 2 you knows, 1 so, 1 but, 2 ands. Alexander had 11 uhs, 1 ums. And you know a so, and an
how many total?
A bunch.
Total?
A bunch.
A bunch. $3.
20.
A bunch.
Adam Daryl Daly.
Thank you.
Person in terms of timing went into the abattoir and only that person was
the meat into the slaughterhouse. Is that
yeah. Reese had 5 to 7 minutes. He went for 9 minutes 14 seconds. Stephanie had 2 to 3 minutes. She went for 1 minute 52 seconds. Dana Mitchell had 5 to 7 minutes. He went for 7 minutes 10 seconds. On the table topics, we had Hattie, you had 1 minute 40 seconds. Lori, you had 1 minute 39 seconds you took. Maddie, you had 1 minute, you took 36 seconds. And Julia, you had 1 minute, you took 39 seconds. Now for the evaluators. First evaluator, Alexander, you had 3 minutes, you took 2 minutes and 34 seconds. Martin Bell, you have 3 minutes, you took 2 minutes and 6 seconds. And Mike Hughes, you have 3 minutes, you took 2 minutes. That is my
nice
report.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Last but not least, we have our grammarian, Mr. Tony.
For the use of the word of the day, I didn't hear too many of them. I guess there wasn't too popular of a word. I heard Sam use it, I heard Dana, I heard Mike, Gus, and Steven. Feel free if I'm wrong, if I missed anyone else. For Sam, the only thing I could catch is I think you said for the overall, I would just say overall, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Stephanie, I really like the phrase a long life overflowing because you can do a lot with that phrase. You can even say a long life overflowing with, and you can pretty much say anything. It gives everyone ideas of what they could use that word for, or the phrase. And then for Rich, jiggle from Jersey. I'm not sure if that's a good or bad use of grammar, but it was very colorful. That is my report.
Thank you.
Evaluation of the whole meeting, everything was great, very entertaining. The room set up, I do apologize, Mike and Hattie, for I noticed that you guys were sitting at first. One thing we have to keep in mind is with the addition of members, and so something I have to keep in mind is that we will have to adjust the room a little bit. It's great that we have members joining us, which means more seats, which is absolutely amazing. So we will have to adjust a few things in the future, the setup of the room, so we can include them into the circle. Into the small room, exactly. But everything was great. The speeches were great. We are pretty much on time. I'd like to call up Julia Kaufman.
Great.
And I'd like an encore. I'd like Rich to come up here, please. While I would love to see an encore.
I have nothing prepared.
Would love to.
You can put it on my chest.
Last week.
people lined up ready to go. So keep working on it. We're on fire to reach our goals as a club. So congratulations, everybody, on that. Good time. All right, so we have, let's make a deal in 2 weeks. I'm passing out a sheet, so everybody signs up and start thinking. It's only in 2 weeks. What's your sales pitch? Can't wait to hear
Rich. Let's get a sale.
Services.
And I know everyone in the room has a service to offer, an item to give, so let's see how much money in your sales pitch you can raise for our club, because we want to have a party. I think I know who someone we can call on a service.
Yeah, Rob will extra money.
And so looking at a Christmas party, I know, Kara, you mentioned about hosting it at your home.
Yeah,
about that.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's have some fun outside our club in our small group, right? So we can have a good time and get to know each other a little bit more. We have an officers meeting tonight. I sent out a survey, a monkey survey. I've gotten about 6 responses. Did you guys get the link?
I finally found it. I'm gonna.
Okay.
I think I did.
I'm going to.
It's supposed to be anonymous. Let's just be at the club. But I'm gonna send it one more time, and then please fill out, give it your feedback, and then I'll report on what everybody says. It's just kind of like a health of the club, what you like, what you don't like, what we can do to make this club even better than it is.
Julie, would you mind resending?
I'll send it again. Yeah.
Some folks may have deleted it.
The other thing I wanted to mention was I got the magazine last night, and I know, Stephen, you've given us a lot of facts about Toastmasters in general, but this is a great infographic about Toastmasters, where we're at. We've got 33,000 members, and just interesting tidbits you might want to take a look at for your interest.
How many?
We have 332,000 members. We're in 135 countries, and we have 15,400 clubs. Pretty significant. So that's kind of interesting facts for you. Let's go through the. All right.
When does Rich speak next?
You know, we have no guests.
No.
This, of all meetings, would have been the meetings of meetings.
Seriously.
I can't tell you how much, that takes a lot of gonads to get up here and to do something like that in an early 30s.
Wow, balls was the first.
You didn't need that one,
It's actually tougher to do for a smaller group than for 400, 500.
Yeah,
really?
Right.
Especially if they're looking right at you. Yeah,
yeah,
it's a little tough.
Especially if you're alcohol.
Yeah, kudos to you. That was really fun, so thank you. All right, we have our lineup for next week. Tony, you're our Toastmaster.
All right.
Ernst, Gus, and Jorge are lined up to speak. Ernst, are you on? For speaker?
I think so.
Very good. Dana, Tabletop Master.
Yeah, buddy.
All right, Erica. We have to see where Erica is. She's our general evaluator. Mike, Rich, Hottie, evaluators next week.
That's
what I'm saying. Oh, Mike, kudos on your evaluation. That was a tough one.
I'm sure he's hanging around after for more.
Do we put the item on? Now?
You can, or just to say yes, you can just say yes, I'm going to. I just want to make sure that everybody's committed for that meeting to be here, plan to get your sales pitch on what you're going to sell, and how much you can try to earn for the club. We're going to have some fun, we're going to have auctions. Sam, know you're our auctioneer?
Yes, that I am.
So that is going to be a fun meeting.
Yeah.
All the way around, win-win on all that. And let's see, Marty, your awe counter. Paul is grammarian, James is timer, so we'll have to check with them how many on that. All right, anything, any news anybody want to share? Because we've got a couple minutes.
When's the division contest?
The division, yes.
Division
is the
11th. Is that this weekend?
Yeah.
This weekend on
the
11th.
Okay.
What time is it?
It's the Mayflower from 3, is it 3 to 5?
I don't know, I'm not there.
I'll send it out in an email.
Kind of like the survey monkey. It is scheduled
for
5:30. I think we're so distracted.
We made so much money.
We didn't do the raffle.
But we do need to pay up. I know I owe a lot of money from the kitty today.
Do we
have... I think there's only a few people haven't paid dues. If you haven't paid dues, pay them to the man over here. I think that's it. We're like...
On the... Tell us a little bit about the Division B. Is that humorous speech and...
Humorous and evaluation.
Evaluation. Okay.
So the next step is Division, the 11th at the Mayflower. And Samuel,
He's an alternate. Okay.
You're an alternate for that. And then it's the district. The district conference, if you've never been there, most of you probably haven't. There's a handful of us. It's a blast. It's at Daytona Beach. It's on the beach. So if you want to go to one of the districts, that's a perfect opportunity. A lot of fun. It's a Friday, Saturday, and then you go home on Sunday morning. Or you can drive back and forth.
So do I need to show up for it as the alternate, or how would that...
Plan for it.
Plan for it, just in case. Absolutely.
Pays to be prepared.
That does.
Yeah, because then if they don't show up,
you
need
to... Do you see the little action figure, sir? That is a huge step for me. Thank you.
It is, yeah.
All right, guys. Wonderful meeting. Have a great week. We'll see you next week. All right.